Good morning, good morning, good morning, and welcome to The Good Life with me, Eileen. We are here on The Good Life Friday, and we're here to open your mind. Good morning, good morning, good morning. How are y'all this morning? It is the Good Life Friday, and usually I have somebody sitting in the studio with me, but today I don't because the listeners are going to be my my sounding board today. I want to discuss exactly what the good life is. We have been talking about what the good life looks like, what it sounds like, what it feels like for about a year and a half now. And so I really want to have some feedback from the listeners. You know, a lot of my favorite listeners, I know, Sekou, you're going to want to stay tuned, especially for the second segment, because I think you're really going to want to, you know, call in on that one. I know Brother Mims is going to call in. I know a lot of our, Eric, a lot of our regular listeners, and as well as, you know, some of our listeners that listen and don't call in. You know, we go out in the community and we have lots of conversations and people are like, oh, I listen to you. And I'm like, well, why don't you call in? We love our first time caller. So please give us a call today at 504-260-9265. That is 564-260-9265. And tell us what the good life looks like to you. Especially over this past year and a half, you know, we discuss Money Monday, Relationship Tuesday, Wellness Wednesday, Gumbo Talk Thursday, and the Good Life Friday. I've interviewed, you know, politicians. I've interviewed, you know, leaders in the community, community leaders, you know, civic leaders. I have interviewed, you know, some of our youth. I've interviewed, you know, literally the gauntlet. And for me, you know, opening your mind to living differently in the world, that's what the good life is all about. It's not necessarily something that's monetary. It's not something that is, you know, flying here, there, and everywhere. But of course, you know, we all enjoy the luxuries of life, but it's enjoying the simple things, having a conversation with a family member, you know, giving somebody a hug, reaching out to someone who's less fortunate, you know, opening your mind to living differently in the world. So I chose three of my favorite songs, and of course it would all be the same artist, India Irie. And so I'm going to play the one song through each segment and kind of go from there on exactly what the good life looks like to me. And I want you to call in and express what the good life looks like to you. And I think you'll really enjoy these songs. They will warm your heart, they will touch your soul, and they will have you, you know, feeling what the good life is. So we're going to go into our first songs, and India Irie is one of my favorite artists. Her record Testimony, which came out, oh, maybe like almost 15 years ago. And I know I'm one of those people, I don't keep up with music all the time, but the ones I love and enjoy, I keep them near and dear to my heart. So I want you to listen to this song and we'll discuss what the good life is right after it.
Back when I had a little, I thought that I needed a lot. A little was overrated, but a lot was a little too complicated. See, zero didn't satisfy me, a million didn't make me happy. That's when I learned the lesson that it's all about your perceptions. Hey, are you a papa or a superstar? So you act, so you feel, so you are. It ain't about the size of your car, it's about the size of the faith in your heart. There's hope, it doesn't cost a thing to smile. You don't have to pay to laugh, you better thank God for that. There's hope, it doesn't cost a thing to smile. You don't have to pay to laugh, you better thank God for that. Country of Brazil, I met a young brother that made me feel that, I could accomplish anything. You see, just like me, he wanted to sing. He had no windows and no doors, he lived a simple life and was extremely poor. On top of all of that, he had no eyesight, but that didn't keep him from seeing the light. He said, us are like in the USA, and all I did was complain. Living here is paradise. He taught me paradise is in your mind. You know that there's hope, it doesn't cost a thing to smile. You don't have to pay to laugh, you better thank God for that. Turn on the TV.
There's hope.
Somebody's acting crazy.
There's hope.
If you let it, it'll drive you crazy.
There's hope.
But I'm taking back my power today.
There's hope.
Gas prices, they just keep on rising.
There's hope.
The government, they keep on lying. We gotta keep on surviving. Keep living our truth and do the best we can do. Cause there's hope.
It doesn't cost a thing to smile. You don't have to pay to laugh. You better thank God.
Hope. How many of us have lost that feeling of hope? Listening to NDIRE, you know, I listen to that song on a regular basis. It just brings that back for me, you know, especially during this political season and watching all the craziness that goes on in the world. And part of the good life for me is hope and remembering the things that bring us together rather than the things that divide us. And one of those things that divide us every day that we don't really pay attention to or realize is stress. And we talk about it, you know, kind of throughout the week between money, relationships, wellness, you know, the hot topics that are going through, going on in the world. You know, stress weighs us down. It drains our energy. It weakens our health and invites us to be negative people. It can be brought on by relational causes, arguing, division, bitterness, and there are excessive causes that we deal with every day, like overworking, overplaying, and overspending. And there are deficiencies like not getting enough rest, nutrition, or exercise. And oftentimes we inflict these daggers on ourselves, and it sets us up to be very irritable. So we need to get back to the basics and pay attention to what really grounds us so that we can live the good life. Because life is a marathon. It is not a sprint. It means that we must balance, prioritize, and pace ourselves. You know, too often we throw caution to the wind and run full steam ahead doing what feels right at that moment. And soon we're gasping for air, wound up in knots and ready to just snap on anyone who comes in our path. You know, the increasing pressures can wear away at our patience and our relationships. So I want everyone to, you know, really look inside, you know, self-reflect and remember what brought you happiness. What are your passions? What gave you hope? Sometimes it's just opening your mind to living differently in the world and giving a different perspective on life. You know, we've had conversations about generational things. And we'll get into that, you know, in our next segment. You know, having those conversations, you'll really enjoy the next segment as well. But it's really opening our minds to living differently in the world. What are you going to work for every day? You know, a lot of people are on their way to work right now or they're sitting at their desk. What are you working for? Are you working for, you know, a bigger car? Are you working for, you know, your school for your children? Are you working for just to, you know, beat your neighbor? What are you working for? You know, are you working for, is it your passion? Is it something that, you know, you feel like you are compelled to do, that it is, you know, your purpose in life? Are you helping someone else? Are you doing for your neighbor? What are you doing for others? Or is it just for yourself and your own self-interest? Is it a selfish act every day that you go to work? We have Aaron, who's a first-time caller. Aaron, welcome to The Good Life. We're opening people's mind this morning. What is a good life to you?
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm all right. I just want to let you know you're a bad woman. Not bad in the, you know.
Not bad mean a bad, but bad mean a good. All right. Thank you.
I just want to say, you know, we just got to just get to that place where we just live our life and not let life obstacles dictate to who we are. You know, I mean,
yes.
You know, things in life is going to come up, it's going to happen, but you can't control that. You know, you just do what you can do and you just make your life, you know, be as easy and respectable as possible. And once you begin to respect self and respect, you know, who you are, it's going to make it easier for you to respect others. You hear me?
Absolutely, Aaron. And I think that's really so fundamental because that's one of the pieces I wanted to get out of this first segment today, focusing on ourself first. Because there's so many times where we like to point the fingers at other people. But until we, you know, ground ourselves and even understand who we are, because sometimes I think we run away from who we are. You know, I have to raise my hand because I ran away from who I was for so many years and God caught up with me and he said, no, I need you to be on the radio. Me, radio, I never thought I was ever going to do this. But look where I am today.
There you go.
And, you know, you're placed, you are put places to do what your purpose is. So what is your purpose? What are you doing every day? Are you helping someone else? You know, reaching back. Is there something that touched your life? What does a good life look like to you, Aaron?
Well, a good life to me is just like you say, you know what I mean? Really and truly, the good life is when you basically just helping others, you know?
Mm.
Because when you begin to help others, it's like you helping yourself. You're doing two for one.
Right.
Because I'm a member of the Fatherhood Roundtable.
Okay.
And, you know, it's like, oh, I forgot what I wanted to say.
Ah, go ahead.
So much I want to say trying to get it all out. But yeah, though, it's like, you know, when you begin to meet people, it's like you building bridges, you know?
Yeah.
And that's why I used to always say, well, I still always say, you never want to, whenever you meet somebody, always treat them how you want to be treated because you never know who you're going to need and who's going to help you out in the long run. You call that building resources.
Thank you,
Aaron. You know, and a wise person asks me, you want to be rich, you want to be wealthy, or you want to have resources?
Thank you.
And the answer to the question is, you want resources because all that other stuff is going to come naturally. But when you have resources, your riches and your wealth, all that's going to come.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Aaron, for your call. It's all about the golden rule, y'all. And we've had these conversations on the show before, but sometimes we need to be reminded. What is the golden rule? Treat others how you want to be treated. Let's remember that. That's part of the good life. That's one of the basic fundamentals of the good life for me. And, you know, I fall off. Everybody falls off at some time. But it's bringing yourself back up, asking for forgiveness, and moving forward and not holding on to that shame, that guilt, and that anger. And so many of us in our society today are really holding on to that anger, but it's really poisoning us. I'm going to go to the lines. I have a friend that's calling in. I have Matt Owens. Matt, good morning. How are you?
Good morning. What are y'all doing over there?
We're talking about the good life, and I know you're living the good life a little bit later today.
I try to live the good life every minute of the day.
Well, what does the good life look like to you?
Oh, today the good life looks like me on stage in front of a bunch of people making a fool of myself. I think that would be pretty good.
If y'all don't know who Matt Owens is, he is one of my favorite comedians. He is in the group, or I should say in our group of The Good Laugh, Relationship Tuesday going up on a Friday. And if you haven't seen him, you definitely will. Our next event is March 25th, and we are finalizing that. And so we will launch it next week and tell everybody about the specifics. But if you want to see Matt, you can see him tonight. Matt, where are you going to be?
Tonight we're at the Joy Theater. It's Matt Owens and Stand Up Nola present. I'm sorry, Matt Owens and Joy Productions present Stand Up Nola, and we've got I've got a bunch of great comedians on the show with me tonight. I've got Chris True, Laura Sanders, Sherby Carter, Dane Fauché, Kamari Stevens, and Lauren LeBourg. And I've got something really special planned. I've got a really big surprise planned for the show tonight. A local music legend is going to help me open the show tonight.
What?
Yeah.
So what time should everybody be there tonight?
Oh, the doors open at 7, show starts at 8. And everybody, you need to be on time tonight because I'm telling you, the opening of the show is going to be amazing.
Well, y'all, Matt has been in the studio and he is funny. But when you see him in person, he is literally hilarious. I can't even, no, I'm so serious. It's like a different level of funny that I didn't even know that I had inside of me to like laugh that hard. You really were amazing. And my sister called me after the show and she was like, he was really funny. Like he was one of the best ones that was up there. So I have to give you your props. No, seriously, Matt, you were off the chain. And it's funny, when Lee wrote you up this morning, he said, yeah, the one that looks like Michael McDonald.
Yeah, you know, Michael McDonald, I think that I think people need to come see me live too, because you know, I maybe you would agree what I look like and my act is probably two very different things, wouldn't you say?
Absolutely. So make sure you go to the Joy tonight, 7 p.m. and go, you know, support Matt Owens. He, you know, is one of my favorite comedians. He's here on WBOK with me all the time, and he is part of the Good Laugh. Relationship Tuesday goes up on a Friday. So make sure you support him tonight, 7 p.m. at the Joy.
Please come see us and live the good life. Share the love.
Yes, absolutely.
Love on everybody.
Love on every. Oh, gosh. I don't know how you. Look, we're going to reel that back in. Thanks, Matt, for calling.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye. We have line two. We have Mr. Gary Lewis Sr. Good morning. How are you? Oh, I think I dropped him. Well, we are going to take a quick break. Mr. Lewis, please call back in. We're going to take a quick break, and we are going to go into our next segment. And, y'all, make sure that you stay tuned for this, because we're going to play a song called Better People, and that's part of the good life. That's what it's all about. So we are going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back. Look, I can't even get it together. It's the Good Life Friday. We're opening your minds to living differently in the world today, y'all. Stay tuned.
Gentile Italian Pies, home to the $5 Family Happy Hour. Specials on pizza, wings, and drinks, Tuesday through Thursday, 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. Gentile Italian Pie does fresh for the entire family. Salads, pizza, pasta, wings, and oven-baked sandwiches. Gentile Italian Pie offers lunch and dinner in a new, modern atmosphere surrounded by big-screen TVs. Dine in or carry out by calling 504-826-9180. That's 504-826-9180. Relax. Have a drink from the fully stocked bar or beer on tap while your order is made from the freshest ingredients. Gentile Italian Pie, 4706 Paris Avenue, is home where everybody knows your name. So bring the family to Paris and Marabou for the $5 Family Happy Hour, Tuesday through Thursday, 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. That's Gentile Italian Pie. Dine in or carry out. 504-826-9180. That's 504-826-9180. You gotta try the pie. That's the original Italian pie, located at Paris and Mirabel in Gentilly.
L&R Security keeps our family, friends, and event goers safe. And to do that job, they are looking for you. L&R Security Services is now hiring persons for the New Orleans Jazz and Heritage Festival, armed and unarmed guards. All interested persons should contact L&R Security Office at 504-943-3191. Fill out an application at L&R's office at 3930 Old Gentilly Road, that's New Orleans, Louisiana. To become one of the proud workers of L&R Security, the minimum requirements are 18 years of age, a completed work application, and criminal background check. Two forms of ID, whether it be a driver's license, state ID, military ID, social security card, or other forms of picture ID. L&R Security is looking for qualified employees to assist in keeping the New Orleans Jazz and Heritage Festival safe. They are looking for you. Again, contact them at 504-943-3191. 504-943-3191. L&R is always looking for armed and unarmed guards. If this is your profession, they're looking for you. Do you know anyone with less than perfect credit? At KB Enterprises, they specialize in restoring your score. Learn how to increase your credit score with 100% satisfaction guarantee. A-plus rating with the BBB, 10-year track record of removing negative items including repossessions, foreclosures, bankruptcies, tax liens, student loans, and more. Kenneth Barnes and his team at KB Enterprises are excited about helping you restore your credit and achieving your financial goals. Whether it's acquiring a home or purchasing a car, don't miss this opportunity to change your life forever. For more info, give them a call at 504-577-4139. Log on to www.kennethbarnes.org and be sure to tune into The Good Life on Money Mondays and get your financial tips for the week from Kenneth Barnes so you can live the good life too.
Hi, this is Norman Robinson. New Orleans East Hospital is open and providing quality health care in your neighborhood. The New Orleans East Hospital is bringing our finest physicians into a beautiful new facility where you receive compassionate, caring service. Emergency room services at New Orleans East Hospital are some of the best in the region. To learn more, visit our website at noehospital.org. Your health matters to us at New Orleans East Hospital.
Awesomely amazing, the facts made clear. Data News Weekly, the paper to cheer. The people's paper for natural growth. Honorable achievers achieving the most. Data News Weekly, the future of our youth. In the city of New Orleans, without excuse. Understanding the expression, Black Lives Matter, yet we're failing to climb the ladder. The absence of love, the missing link. It's time we commit to effectively think, uplifting our women, families as well. Safer communities in order to excel. Managing anger, developing our minds. Data News Weekly, preventing decline. Restoring our decency, restoring our faith. Thoroughly conscious, removing disgrace. The best of character constantly applied. Self-determination, no one denied. Mothering children, mothers up to par. The purpose of life beyond a star. So let us prioritize what is urgently needed. Data News Weekly, regression defeated. No longer distracted, no longer confused. So great is the substance of Data News.
Pick up your copy of Data News Weekly today.
Back on the air. Let's go to the phones. Caller, let me help you.
Hi. So I've been trying to get my landlord to fix my washing machine for weeks, but he keeps avoiding me. What do I do?
Excellent question. Well, have you been to AT&T?
Why? Is my landlord there?
No, but when you have AT&T Wireless and DirecTV, you can get unlimited data.
Sounds great. But how about fix my washer?
Well, it won't. But now that AT&T and DirecTV have joined forces, you can enjoy your favorite DirecTV shows on your phone while you're counting quarters at the local laundromat.
Sweet.
Sweet indeed. AT&T, mobilizing your world.
Come into AT&T now and get the Samsung Galaxy S6.
Must have eligible TV service. If you're not eligible, AT&T will move you to a new plan and overage charges may apply. After 22 gigabytes of data usage, AT&T may reduce speeds. TV content varies by device, location, and package. Monthly and other charges, usage, and other restrictions apply. See store for plan details.
Talk radio, heard around the globe. New Orleans Zone, WBOK 1230 AM and WBOK1230AM.com. Real talk for real times.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, and welcome back to The Good Life with me, Eileen. We are here on The Good Life Friday, and we're here to open your mind. The Good Life Radio Show is brought to you by Morris Reed Jr., a New Orleans law firm. If you have been hit in a car accident or charged with a crime, call 504-488-HELP. That's 504-488-4357. The Morris Reed Jr. Law Firm is a full-service law firm that fights vigorously to get you the money you deserve. If you or a loved one has been injured in a car accident or you have been charged with a crime, call Morris Reed Jr. and let their experienced, highly qualified attorneys provide you with expert legal help today. Call 504-488-HELP. That's 504-488-4357. 504-488-4357, because that is the good life. Now we're going to jump back into the show today because we're discussing exactly what the good life is. It's about opening your mind to living differently in the world. We talk about it all the time. Love, compassion, understanding, and tolerance. I have Mr. Gary Lewis back on the line. Welcome to the good life, Mr. Lewis. How are you?
All right. How you doing, Ms. Arlene?
I am blessed. How are you?
I'm blessed too. Every time you open my eyes.
There you go. I know.
Yeah, another day we never suffered for.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, we blessed. We be blessed about being black people of the city of New Orleans and all the rest of the United States of America.
Mm-hmm.
When we learn how to respect each other like men and women,
mm-hmm.
and come together as one.
Absolutely.
That's so, this city here.
Absolutely.
I want to give a shout out to some people I know.
Go ahead.
That's them too, Miss Louise Williams.
Mm-hmm.
One of them, Miss Riley. Miss Riley. Riley. You're still in the waist. We're still behind you, Miss Riley.
Yes, absolutely,
and
Tracy. Absolutely.
Mustang Sally.
Absolutely.
That's Miss Mustang Sally. And Mr. Brother Carl Gammon, too.
Absolutely.
Every brother.
Absolutely.
Cinco, too.
Yes.
I'll be with him, too.
So what does a good life look like to you, Mr. Lewis?
My good life is when we and Allie come together as one.
And you know what? That is a great intro for my next song.
Life.
Thank you so much for your call.
And I understand. When that CD going to come out on Chombo and Charlie, our cousin?
You know what? I'll have to call his brother and ask him. I will find out and announce it as soon as they give me the information.
Yes,
Leroy Hill is his brother. As you all know, I did a contest to get my theme music, and his brother, you know, submitted his song. So my theme music is trombone. I mean, not trombone, I'm sorry. Trumpet Black. And speaking of it, every time I say his name, if anybody knows who stole his trumpet from his funeral, y'all wrong for that. Call the police.
Ain't nobody but the family members did that.
Well, they need to get the trumpet back because that's just crazy.
They're going to get it back.
They are.
They're going to get it. They're
absolutely.
They're going to be over accountable for it, too. They know you're wrong with it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And a lot of people waiting on that CD to come out.
Well, we will let you know as soon as it does. I have a great relationship with them, and, you know, we're stuck together for life, obviously. We get to hear, you know, Trumpet Black every morning, Monday through Friday here. His legacy will continue, and that's exactly part of the good life for me as well.
And we got a lot of entertainment,
Yes.
See, my thing is here, I'm going to say it before I get off, and I say it on the grapevine, too, about these Indians who they have a rally, not a rally. A thing like you want to have a seminar for the makeup Indian costume.
Oh.
And my thing is here. Why go that way? This chief queer wild west. The chief, he want to have a seminar to have people know how to make Indian costume.
Mm-hmm.
My thing is here. See, my thing is this is a black thing, not a white thing. And our chief, the veteran chief that dead and gone out, Trudy Montana, Bo Dollar, none of them ain't never did none of this here.
Mm-hmm.
But he won't bring this to the forefront.
Well, maybe that's a conversation we can have. And I'll talk to Graylin. Maybe he wants to have
and
we'll invite some Indians.
Don't sell your people out.
Absolutely. Well,
don't sell this culture out.
Thank you, Mr. Lewis, for your call.
That's what the white man want. Don't set a culture out. He stole everything he could. Anybody.
Thank you so much for your call.
We got a culture. They don't have none. We got one.
Thank you so much, Mr. Lewis, for your call. And, you know, he actually speaks to what our next song is all about. The song is called Better People. It's about India. It's written by NDIRE. You know, us as generational conversations, you know, we're easily angered. And when you're easily angered, it's an indicator that there's a hidden area of selfishness or insecurity present where love is supposed to rule. Did y'all hear me when I said that? When you're easily angered, it's an indicator that there's a hidden area of selfishness or insecurity that's present where love is supposed to overrule. So we have this song by NDIRE. It's called Better People, and I want everyone to listen to it, and we'll discuss it, you know, right after it goes off. Go ahead.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. I wish there was a video game to teach you your ancestor name. I wish there was a phone number, like 1-800-SAVE-YOUR-BROTHER. I'm thankful for the radio station, not afraid to put the truth in rotation. There is certain information that you can only get in conversation with young people. Or talk to old people, it would make a shine. All around. But talk to young people. It would make us up. Tell people. All around. As it would. Yeah, yeah. We went from radio to TV. Now we're going from LP to CD. Don't be afraid to try something new. I can help you with the brand new technology. Help me with the age old philosophy.
The message of that, then I'm sorry, because I need you to go look up Better People by India Irie. Put it on your playlist and let it sink in. We need to create better people, a better community. Stop pointing fingers. I don't really care what color you are. We're all on this earth together. We need to start looking at each other as a community, but our communities need to get together and then branch out to other communities, because we're all sisters and brothers of everyone in the world. So we need to start having these conversations. And we did that a little bit last Friday with the millennials. But we really need the generations to start having those conversations. There's so much that you can teach us, but there's so much that we can teach you. And we need to listen to one another. And I mean active listening. We need to open our minds to living differently in the world. Because I grew up in a different scenario. The millennials that were here last Friday grew up in a totally different age of technology. My son has only seen basically a black president. How amazing is that? And my parents grew up in a segregated city and country. I mean, just the three generations there, we all have different frame of references. So we need to have those conversations so we can understand where we come from, but we need to also plan a better future so that we can walk into that future as a community, not leaving anyone behind. Because so many times we do that. You know, we might get ahead a little bit here or there, and then we leave somebody lagging behind. And that's not community. That's not what it needs to be about. We need to be the change that we want to see in the world. She said it, open your mind to living differently in the world. If you are one of the, you know, more mature generation who knows things, you know, reach back and tell somebody. If they're not willing to listen, there's someone else who is. You know, don't stop at the first person. You know, God gives us test and the devil gives us temptation. So we need to recognize which one it is. And if it's a test, move through the test, move through the fear, keep going, open your mind, love, compassion, understanding, tolerance. But tolerance is the big thing, because so many times we hit a brick wall and we just stop. Break through the wall. Tolerance, the one that is easily angered, is the one that generally has the selfish problem or the insecurity problem. We're supposed to be leading from love. Are you leading from love? Or are you leading from a place of insecurity? I really want you to like take a moment and have self-reflection and look and think about that. How do you react to people? How do you confront people? How do you have conversation? And do you actually listening? If you are talking in your head or thinking while someone else is talking, you're not listening to them. You're not having a conversation. You're basically, you know, having a debate because you're preparing to respond. So how are we really talking to each other? We want to open people's minds to living differently in the world, and we need to start with ourselves. And that is the good life. Open your mind to living differently in the world. We're going to take a quick break. This is the Good Life Friday, y'all. We're opening your mind today. Make sure you stay tuned. I have another song for you, and you don't want to miss it. We'll be right back.
We welcome our listeners to join us for Frankly Fridays, where dialogue meets debate. Your week in your words with Dr. W.L.T. Littleton every Friday at 11 a.m. on WBOK, Real Talk for Real Times.
Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be.
Attention band directors, if your school has a marching band, concert band, or jazz band, please consider submitting an application for the Class Got Brass Contest. And your chance to win up to $10,000 for your school's music program. Class Got Brass is a program of the New Orleans Jazz and Heritage Foundation to support music education in schools while also promoting the brass band tradition. Middle schools and high schools are invited to create a brass band of up to 12 members and to perform classic songs from the brass band repertoire. Then they'll take part in the main event, a Battle of the Bands, on Sunday, March 20th in Armstrong Park. At stake are more than $30,000 worth of instruments, instrument repair, and other supplies. Every band that participates will get a prize. Find out all the details at classgotbrass.com. The deadline to apply is March 7th. Class Got Brass is presented by the New Orleans Jazz and Heritage Foundation.
This is your legal line of the day, brought to you by the Hilliard Law Firm. When a family member who owns a home or other property dies, the legal ownership of their property is transferred to their heirs. But this does not happen automatically. The process of transferring ownership from the deceased to their heirs is called a succession. In many instances, when the bank or financial institution is alerted that an account holder has passed away, the bank account of the deceased will be frozen until the proper legal documentation is provided. So whether the deceased owned immovable property such as a house or just a bank account, the heir or heirs may have to open a succession in order to obtain ownership of the property. If you are faced with the death of a loved one, please consult an attorney who will provide you with advice that is specific to your situation. This was your legal line of the day, brought to you by the Hilliard Law Firm. For more information, call 504-729-6133.
Hi, this is Norman Robinson. New Orleans East Hospital is open and providing quality health care in your neighborhood. The New Orleans East Hospital is bringing our finest physicians into a beautiful new facility where you receive compassionate, caring service. Emergency room services at New Orleans East Hospital are some of the best in the region. To learn more, visit our website at noehospital.org. Your health matters to us at New Orleans East Hospital.
Gentile Italian Pies, home to the $5 Family Happy Hour. Specials on pizza, wings, and drinks, Tuesday through Thursday, 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. Gentile Italian Pie does fresh for the entire family. Salads, pizza, pasta, wings, and oven-baked sandwiches. Gentile Italian Pie offers lunch and dinner in a new, modern atmosphere surrounded by big-screen TVs. Dine in or carry out by calling 504-826-9180. That's 504-826-9180. Relax. Have a drink from the fully stocked bar or beer on tap while your order is made from the freshest ingredients. Gentile Italian Pie, 4706 Paris Avenue, is home where everybody knows your name. So bring the family to Paris and Marabu for the $5 Family Happy Hour, Tuesday through Thursday, 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. That's Gentile Italian Pie. Dine in or carry out, 504-826-9180. That's 504-826-9180. You gotta try the pie. That's the original Italian pie, located at Paris and Mirabeau in Gentilly.
L&R Security keeps our family, friends, and event goers safe. And to do that job, they are looking for you. L&R Security Services is now hiring persons for the New Orleans Jazz and Heritage Festival, armed and unarmed guards. All interested persons should contact L&R Security Office at 504-943-3191. Fill out an application at L&R's office at 3930 Old Gentilly Road, that's New Orleans, Louisiana. To become one of the proud workers of L&R Security, the minimum requirements are 18 years of age, a completed work application, and criminal background check. Two forms of ID, whether it be a driver's license, state ID, military ID, social security card, or other forms of picture ID. L&R Security is looking for qualified employees to assist in keeping the New Orleans Jazz and Heritage Festival safe. They are looking for you. Again, contact them at 504-943-3191. 504-943-3191. L&R is always looking for armed and unarmed guards. If this is your profession, they're looking for you.
WBOK 1230 AM, the People's Station.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, and welcome back to The Good Life with me, Eileen. We are here on The Good Life Friday, and we're here to open your mind. We are back on The Good Life Friday, and hopefully I'm opening your mind to living differently in the world, because that's exactly what I wanted to do. You know, there's all kind of music on the air today, but personally, The Good Life for me is really listening to those artists that inspire me to open my mind to living differently in the world, the same thing that I say every day. And so I've been, you know, playing a little bit of India Arie this morning to, you know, plant some seeds, you know, to open your mind. Sometimes when you hear it from one person, you might not get it, but when you hear it in a different way or a different perspective, or it's just shown in a little bit of a different manner, it's tweaked, you know, it's easier, it's more digestible, I should say that. So, you know, we wanted to really discuss love. Love will lead you to forgive instead of holding a grudge, to be grateful instead of greedy, to be content rather than rushing into more debt. Love encourages you to be happy when someone else succeeds rather than lying awake at night in envy. Love says, share the inheritance rather than fight with your relatives. It reminds you to prioritize your family rather than sacrifice them for a promotion at work. In each decision, love ultimately lowers your stress and helps you release the venom that can build up inside. It then sets up your heart to respond to your family, your community, and yourself in love. And that is The Good Life. I'm going to go to line two. I have Miss Carol on the line. Good morning, Miss Carol. How are you?
Good morning. How are you?
I am blessed. How are you?
I'm doing good. I just want to first start out by saying that I'm glad to say I'm one of those millennials that you're talking about. I
yes.
was born in 89 and graduated in 2007. So
yes. So how has, number one, what does The Good Life look like to you? And what did you think about the song Better People? You know, having, you know, people talking to each other and really understanding the other points of view.
I believe you're really making people really look deeper into themselves and, you know, check the speck of dust in their own eyes before they can look at somebody else, because I know I'm guilty of when someone's talking to me, I'm just sitting here, okay, I wish they'd stop. I wish, you know.
We all are. We all are.
I just can't wait, you know, just anticipating my own chance to talk and mm-hmm. not really listening to them. So I know listening is very key to any conversation or relationship.
Absolutely, absolutely. So thank you so much. So what does The Good Life look like to you?
The Good Life looks like everybody loving each other.
Mm.
You know, if we all loved each other, then we would all prosper.
Mm. And we would treat each other how we wanted to be treated.
Exactly.
Imagine that.
Very simple. It's amazing. It's a very simple solution, but we have problems doing it.
Right. But, you know, we're all human. We're all flesh. But it's reminding ourselves and keeping it at the forefront of our mind and being mindful, you know,
yeah.
and being present and really understanding, you know, what's going on, because it is so important. Opening people's minds.
And being accountable. I think
yes.
You have to be accountable for what you're doing.
Yes. And, you know, ask for forgiveness.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Ask for forgiveness. I think it makes you a stronger person, personally. Person
yeah.
who can't ask for forgiveness, you know, that's the person I side-eye. Because I'm like, you know, you've done something in your life that you at least should be sorry for, right?
We all have things that we have to change throughout our entire life. You know, something always has to change. It's because our life changes, daily things. So don't think that you're okay and you don't need to fix anything. We all have our issues.
Exactly. And here's the clincher. When someone asks for forgiveness and you offer them that forgiveness,
mm-hmm.
let it go.
Yeah.
Stop berating them for something that they did 5 days ago. You're laughing, but I'm serious. 5 weeks ago or 5 years ago. How do you expect that person to grow if you remind them every day of what they're not?
Yeah. You can't live in the past.
You cannot live in the past. And
nope.
you are basically, that poison is living inside you because you really didn't forgive them.
Mm-hmm.
So
you're harboring it. And it's hurting you just as much as it's hurting them.
There you go.
It might be hurting you more.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, we do this with the people who are closest to us, honestly, you know, especially our children and our family members. Because, you know, our friend, you're like, oh, yeah, they did me something last week and you let that slide. Really? But your sister or your brother or your mother or your father, something happened and, you know, you remember that forever. And, you know, oh, yeah. it's the next Christmas and you're still talking about it. Really? Let's be happy that we're all alive. Some people didn't wake up and make it to the next Christmas.
Yeah.
Y'all, it's about to be Easter. He's about to rise again. Open your mind to living differently in the world. You know, kumbaya with the family. Right?
Yes.
All right. Now
that
you're going to. Right, exactly. Right. There you go. I don't know about that, but okay. But what I do want to say is it's a choice. And so yes. I want you to listen to this next song because I think you're going to enjoy it. This song is I Choose by India Irie.
Because you never know what life is going to take you and you can't change where you've been. But today I have the opportunity to choose. Here I am now looking at 30 and I got so much to say. Gotta get this off of my chest, I gotta let it go today. I was always too concerned about what everybody would think. But I can't live for everybody, I gotta live my life for me, yeah. I've reached a fork in the road of my life, and ain't nothing gonna happen unless I decide to be the best that I can be.
I choose
to be authentic in everything
I do.
My past don't dictate who I am.
I choose,
yeah. I'd have been through some painful things I thought that I would never make it through. Filled up with shame from the top of my head to the soles of my shoes. I put myself in so many chaotic circumstances. By the grace of God, I've been given so many second chances. But today I decided to let it all go. I'm dropping these bags, I'm making room for my joy.
I choose
to be the best that I can be.
I choose
to be authentic and everything
I do.
My past don't dictate who I am.
I choose.
Because you never know what life is gonna take you, and you can't change where you've been.
But today, I have the opportunity to choose.
Release the guilt about my dreams having the way they think, 'cause life is gonna do what it do.
And every day
Irie. Y'all, it's a choice. At what point are you going to choose to drop your bags? Don't let the past dictate who you are. Drop the shame, the guilt, and everything that you've done in your past. You know, we are used for our purposes generally because of our mistakes of our past, because we can be a testimony for someone else. By no means am I perfect. And actually, I was at New Home Ministries Baptist Church last night, and I was speaking with R.C. Blakes, and his story is amazing. If you don't follow him on Periscope, make sure that you do. He is on there every day with a message. You know, he talks about, you know, how he lived his life in the past and where he has been. But, you know, I was actually talking to the millennials about this in the recording room maybe about 2 weeks ago. And I said, if you were going to a church, which church would you be more comfortable in? In the pastor who has been perfect all of their lives, or with the pastor who has made mistakes and who has turned their life around and who can now preach from that perspective? And we have preachers and churches of both. But sometimes if you're not a perfect person, you may feel more perfect, more comfortable with someone who maybe has, you know, erred in their life and they have, you know, turned their life around. Because it's easier to, you know, see yourselves in who they are. And so many times we carry this mask of perfection, you know, this representative like that we like to, you know, we like to face the world with. It gets tiresome. Doesn't it get tiresome? Don't you feel like there is a weight? At what point are you going to start being your authentic self, being exactly who you are? And you don't have to apologize for who you are. You know, sometimes it's just as easy as, you know what, I appreciate your point of view, but I'm going to agree to disagree because I've tried it your way. It doesn't work. Now I'm compelled to do it my way because I need to do me and I need to love me. Now, don't be disrespectful, but you can do it lovingly. You know, love is a choice. Love doesn't erase the past, but it totally makes the future different. So if this is touching you, you know, we have a few minutes left. Give us a call at 504-260-9265. 504-260-9265. What does the good life look like to you? You know, for me, it's, you know, opening people's minds to living differently in the world. And I say that every day, but it really is. When I go out and I, you know, I had a conversation at the Generations Mixer and I was speaking to this young guy and he was like, you know, I listen to Relationship Tuesday and my wife listens to it too. And they listen to it separately and they go home at night and they have conversations about it. And he's like, I appreciate that you let the guys be who they are and give their opinion without interrupting them. And I was like, really? We don't understand how simple that is. Or maybe you do out there. Maybe you're in a relationship where someone isn't listening to you, or, you know, they need just a different perspective or see it from a different point of view. And sometimes them hearing the conversation separately and being able to come back together, you know, that has worked for them. And I was inspired and humbled. I was like, me, what we do in the studio every day, you know, if I can help one person and open one person's mind and, you know, sow a seed that they can reap in the future that, you know, inspires them, then I've done my job. What are you doing to be a better person? What are you doing to reach out to your community? Sometimes it's as little as listening or having a generational conversation. You know, we love our mature generations. You know, Sekou, we love you. We need to understand your point of view. But I need you to be able to deliver the information in a digestible form so that we can both come to the table and we can come forth with ideas and we can come forth with action plans and policies that can move us all forward so that we're just not worried about pointing out this one, this, that one, and the other, or this other colored person, or green, blue, purple, black, and brown. I'm not worried about green, blue, purple, black, and brown. I'm worried about us. I'm worried about us. I'm worried about our community. I'm worried about our earth. We need to save the world. And I'm worried about, you know, this Saturday we have an election and we need to, you know, open our mind and the world's mind and the country to living differently in the world. We need to take a stand. And we need to go out and vote because it's important. Y'all know who I'm voting for. You know, I'm not even going to repeat it. But I want you to educate yourself on, you know, the elected officials and the people that, you know, that are going to be representing you and who can do it best for you. And as well as we have a legislative session, you know, going on right now, you know, pay attention to what's going on. You know, we had Walt Leger on a little bit ago. You know, follow your legislators. See what they're talking about. You know, just be a little bit educated on the topics. You know, let's change policy, because when we change policy, that creates generational change. It's not just, you know, a one-time fix. It's generational change. So we want to open people's minds to living differently in the world. We want to live the good life with love, compassion, understanding, and tolerance. And y'all, please call your legislators. I am going to shout out for this. Please call your legislators about equal pay. It's not a woman's issue. It's a family issue. And that is a good life, taking care of our family and our community, because it can only raise our community up. This is the Good Life Friday. You know, I hope I touched someone today. I know that I was touched with the callers. Thank you, Ms. Carol, Gary, and Aaron. I really appreciate all of your calls. And please continue to listen, because that's what the good life is all about. Thanks, guys. I'm out.